Felix.
It's been a rough few days for Stephanie Carol Kershaw and Felix, her one-year-old cat.
We love you, Felix.
He's our little miracle kitty, so just praying for a full recovery.
He's at Animal Emergency and Referral of Minnesota in Oakdale.
Hi.
Trying to recover from a ride that nobody would take on purpose.
All three cats always come down when I'm down there. I've never seen them go in to the washer or the dryer, but I'd heard about this happening, and so I made sure to always check.
Stephanie was putting laundry in her high-efficiency front-loading washer, and Felix must have jumped in when she left briefly to grab some more clothes.
One godsend is it was on express wash, and I only put it on that, well, for two reasons, to save water, but also to save some time.
Oh, good boy.
She's still traumatized by what she discovered at the end of that 45-minute cycle.
Then heard a little meow, and I looked around because I'm so used to them, you know, being around me. And all of a sudden, I saw a little white back foot go up in the air, and I can't even tell you what that was like. I feel so guilty about that, and I am.
Well, you didn't know.
Yeah. Yeah. In hindsight, I'm so grateful that I didn't leave the house, you know, and go run errands. I could have been gone for 8 hours. You know what I mean? I was there, so I mean, that's helping us get through that.
What are you doing?
It was a frantic trip to the animal ER.
Probably broke every speeding record in the city getting here.
What'd you tell him? Did you just say, my cat went through the wash cycle?
Yeah, my cat went through the wash cycle. And I just thought people are going to think I'm negligent. I'm just the opposite. I'm obsessive about, but I mean, he must have slipped in there when I turned my back.
Oh, you can't come out of here.
Felix is now on oxygen support in one of the ICU units.
He's a little survivor, that's for sure.
And showing gradual improvement.
We're not sure if he recognizes us yet, but he is with some of the vet techs and with us. He's like leaning forward and wanting to be petted.
You're gonna get better, okay?
So that gives me some hope that he knows somebody cares.
I'm so happy he's eating.
Well, just think, it's not just the soap and the water and the lack of air.
We're proud of you.
That spin cycle. How does a 12-pound cat endure that and live to meow about it?
I mean, when you see it, it's a blur. You know what I mean?
He likes chin rubs.
Stephanie says Felix was born on a farm and has always had kind of a freewheeling and rambunctious personality.
He's just not your regular cat. He greets us every time we come to the door.
He acts like he owns the place.
Yeah.
He's just like the cartoon character. He's all over.
Yeah, that's why we named him Felix.
Continuous, in trouble.
Bye-bye, see you.
Some luck and pluck and a will to survive.
Oh, I'm so happy.
Well, Felix is still in critical condition and those medical bills are adding up. So Stephanie's daughter has started a GoFundMe page to help with those costs. It's under Save Felix's Life, Cat Stuck in a Washing Machine. By the way, it was warm water wash and cold water rinse. And
you might say that half jokingly, but that actually makes a giant difference.
Oh, yeah. I mean, yeah,
right.
It does.
Yeah.
One of the reasons she wanted to come forward was just to warn other people to, no matter how careful you are with your pets, and she is, you never know, they're very quick. They can just jump in, and so she wanted to make sure that other people don't have to go through what she's going through and what Felix is going through right now.
You can't imagine what that was like for the cat for 45 minutes.
Well, yeah, at first he was blind. He was acting blind, like he couldn't see, couldn't stand up.
Well, he's,
But now gradually you saw, I mean, he's walking around, he's eating now, and still on oxygen, but doing much better than he was.
Yeah, thanks. Wow, what a wild circumstance, and I hope people can learn from that. Thank you, John.
Yeah, sure.